Hey everyone, today I want to take a look at some mods that can fix and improve Fallout 4. I chose these mods because I consider them somewhat essential for me, and because I feel some of these are left somewhat under the radar. This also means I left out mods that are already considered mandatory even by the most novice modders, such as the script extender and the unofficial patch. The aim of this video is to hopefully give some new ideas for mods that could improve your performance, visual quality and gameplay. As always, I left timestamps in the description and comment section so you can navigate to different parts if you wish to. We start off this list with a big one, which is BeRightBack's texture optimization tool. Some people might be familiar with the guide BeRightBack made back in 2017. The guide itself, however, is somewhat outdated and requires many patches, many of which have to be carefully picked or made, as many existing patches are old and won't play well with some updated mods from the same list. That being said, BeRightBack's texture optimization tool, which is hosted on the same page, is something that I think does deserve a place in this video. This texture optimization tool merges many mods with the vanilla textures for the best results both graphically and performance-wise. In the end, you will have the 15 vanilla texture archives repacked with all the texture mods you probably ever need. There are different repacks you can use with the optimization tool. Just using the main repack of this already includes fan-favorite mods like Vivid All-in-One, HD Clothing Packs, and many miscellaneous retextures. The way the texture optimization handles this, the performance afterwards will be even better than the base vanilla game, while looking way better at the same time. If you're feeling adventurous and have a fairly good machine, you can even install a quality pack on top of the main packs, which has insane texture resolution and comes with many screen archery mods, like Luxor's retexture packs. I don't really recommend using this, but it's your game. If you run on an old PC and it can't handle Fallout 4 very well even without graphic mods, his performance pack might just give you the boost you needed. And now, like I told before, his guide on the same page is somewhat outdated and some mods that are integrated in these repacks might have newer versions available on their main page. However, I'd still consider using this tool to have everything in one go, while going for a very optimized way of adding retextures. The installation process might look a little bit daunting, but it's actually fairly simple. You first download the work folder and extract it somewhere easily accessible for now with a lot of disk space. Go to your Fallout 4 data folder and copy all 15 texture.bsa archives. Place them inside the original BA2 folder inside the workspace you downloaded. Now download the main packs. If you run on a potato, you can use the performance pack on top of the main pack. And for high-end PCs, one can use the quality on top of the main pack. Install the main packs in order with Mod Organizer 2 or Vertex. Optionally, install the quality add-on on top of that, or the performance add-on on top of that, but obviously not both. Now that these are installed, find the files in Mod Organizer 2 or Vertex, starting with the main pack one. You want to copy these files to the patched files folder inside your workbase. There will be overrides, so make sure you drag and drop them in the right order. If you use the optional restyle, performance or quality packs, let those override the main files. Now you can run the installer.bat file you find inside the workbase folder. This will take a very long time, depending on your system and options you chose, of course. When the program is done, you will find 15 repacked BSA files, which you then replace with the original ones in your main data folder. The beauty of this retexture optimization is that even when using just the main pack, the game will already look a lot better, while also performing a lot better. It's guaranteed to be 1000 times better than Bethesda's insulting HD texture DLCs. Next we have Buffout 4. Buffout is a script extender plugin that fixes engine bugs and adds a better crash log. The crash log is a little bit like Papyrus for Skyrim, but with the easier to read crash log. The three requirements to use Buffout 4 are also script extender plugins, so it doesn't add up to ESPs used. I guess it's a small mention, but at some point could be really helpful. It also lets you get Steam achievements in a modded game, much like the achievement mod. Then we have the FPS physics fix. The high FPS physics fix does what it says it does, but has one particular feature that I use it for. With this installed, you can make it so that FPS uncaps during loading screens, providing way faster loading times. Apparently, loading is tied to in-game FPS, so uncapping FPS to a maximum of 350 during loading screens really improves the loading time. The results vary and the benefit is much greater if you use a SSD card. For me, it often reduces loading times by half or more, so it's really worth it for me. Optionally, you can also turn off the background and animations during loading screens, improving load times even further. Now, alternatively, there are other mods. One can use a mod like Load Accelerator to achieve basically the same thing in a slightly different way. Load Accelerator uses a DLL file instead to display it actually works. The downside to this is that you have to do a small ini tweak if you are using an EMB preset or EM boost. I myself prefer high FPS physics fix over Load Accelerator because it purely depends on the Fallout script extender, which most if not all people will use. As told by other mod users, I also feel inclined to say that uncapping FPS at times could really heat up your GPU, so it's not a bad idea to monitor the temperature with a third-party program like MSI Afterburner. To be honest, when modding and stressing your game and PC, it never really is a bad idea to monitor stuff like that. On the other hand, it's quite a bit to actually damage your machine. Next is raw input. Raw input is a universal fix for the mouse. I know many people like to play Fallout with a controller, but I'm not one of those persons, so raw input is a must for me to easily solve all mouse issues. Raw input disables mouse acceleration and mouse smoothing. It also adjusts sensitivity, so it is the same horizontally and vertically, both in-game and in the menus. And finally, it also lets you choose your sensitivity while aiming down sight and scopes. The default is 75%, which feels fine to me. Next we have Sprint Stuttering Fix, which is another fix I like to use. There are many mods that fixes issues with sprinting, and most of them do the same, but with slightly different methods. What this does, without getting too technical, is that it removes the 500 speed limit from the game's memory. Without doing this, it leads to unpleasant stuttering when sprinting on uneven surfaces. The reason I opt for this mod is because it seems the most modular, plays well with bullet times mods that I like to use, and is only dependent on Fallout script extender, making an ESP plugin absolute. Of course, any of these sprint fix mods help, but I still wanted to mention this. And finally, we have Takismar's grind-free game settings, and is more grind-free game settings. The grind-free game settings is a mod that combines a lot of quality of life mods. The same thing can easily be achieved by installing similar mods and some things even by changing some ini settings, but this to me is a convenient way to have them all in two ESPs. The grind-free game settings makes lockpicking even easier by always having the sweet spot on the center. Lockpicking is that easy anyway, so it just saves some time and annoyance for me. You still need to require perk for advanced expert and master locks to be able to lockpick them. Similarly, the hacking also has been altered, so there is no more than one word as a solution. I never liked hacking in Fallout anyway, and as with the lockpicking, you still need the required perks. Grind-free game settings also displays the text on terminals faster, and power lines for settlements are now longer, up to 9 times the normal length. This mod also includes the power armor fix for not aggroing friendly NPCs when you land from a height close to them. Easy sandboxing has also been included in the merge, which makes NPCs' movement behave better when movement is done between multiple floors. And lastly, NPCs move away much faster and further when you bump into them. Takismar's more grind-free game setting has some additional quality of life mods merged. Quest markers will display from further away, so that it doesn't just pop up when you're right next to it. All regular crafting stations can now be built without having to need rank 2 of the local leader perk. Your followers will no longer be jackasses to wild red stacks. Jet will no longer show up in pre-war coolers and containers, and pipe weapons won't appear anymore in safes or trunks. This is a real blessing, actually. More grind-free game settings also lets you craft a ring, which functions as a jetpack to use without power armor. And finally, ringing the bell in a settlement now makes your settlers sprint to the bell instead of crawling towards it. Takismar's mod list isn't a bad place to start if you look for mod recommendations. I personally also like his quest mods and his articles he released over the last years. It's a really fun read. His mod recommendation list itself is also very thorough, extremely modular, and of course it's made by a beloved mod author who knows what he is doing and someone who doesn't shy away from mentioning some more controversial mods, if you're into that kind of thing. Of course, there are many mods that fix different things for Fallout 4, and there are even more quality of life mods. Sometimes it can be hard to choose which mod to use. As is often the case with modding, a lot comes down to personal preference. Regardless, I hope the mods I mentioned here are helpful one way or another. Let me know what mods in this category you can't go without. Now, for anyone familiar with my channel, this was a pretty random video after nearly 2 years of hiatus. I really needed something fairly simple to refresh myself and thought a few recommendations would be a good place to start. Thanks for watching, everyone. Stay safe, have a nice day, and I'll see you all in a year or two.